Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will tell you how we can perform WGC analysis without any requirement of coding. In this video, I will not go into the details of what is WGC analysis, what are its limitations and uses. However, I will only perform WGC analysis using an online tool. So let me show you which files are needed to perform WGC analysis using that online tool. First of all, we should have an internet connection because we need to access online ITAP tool server. And the second, we should have gene counts or the read counts file in the form of Excel, and that Excel file should be exported in the form of CSV. And using that genes or read counts file, we should also prepare that design file. I have already prepared this gene counts and the design file. So let me show you how you can also prepare your gene counts and design file similarly as I have designed. Here I have already prepared my design file and gene counts file in the form of CSV. So let me show you how I prepare my gene counts file. You can see this is my gene count file. In the first column, there is list of all the gene IDs. You can see here all the genes are starting from 80, and we know that 80 refers to the Arabidopsis thaliana. And here is the list of all those treatments, and in this you can see here they have used 18 treatments. Actually, in this experiment they have used two treatments. One is RPM and the second is MGCL2. They have applied actually RPM and MGCL2 on the leaves of Arabidopsis plants, and they checked the growth and compared the RNA-seq data at different days. You can see here in all the columns only the gene counts data is given. You can also give your read counts data from your experiment, but you don't need to give at the end like any log FC value or the p value. You can see here after the gene counts data, there all the columns are empty, so you also don't need to give any log FC value or p value in this column. So you can also use FPKM values rather than this gene count value. If you don't have any this gene read counts data, you can also use FPKM value. So now let me show you that how we can prepare our design file. You can see here all these names should be copy and paste to the design file. You can see here I have already prepared that design file. You can see here there are all those 18 treatments name which I have copied from them, and you can see here I have mentioned that what was the treatment and what were the number of days. You can see here I have just written like RPM, this was the first treatment. You can see here from using this MGCL2, I have just separated MGCL2 and RPM as treatment, and here I have also mentioned number of days like day 3, and here are few at day 4 as well. You can also prepare your design file similarly like I have designed. But if you have still question, I have a separate and detailed video about the preparation of design file and the gene counts file, and its link is given in the description. You can go and watch carefully about the designing of gene counts file and design file. Now you can see here our gene counts and the design file is ready. What we need to go, we need to simply go to the Google and we need to write ITAP. You need to just click on the first link. So first of all, here you need to select your best matching species because our experiment was related to Arabidopsis. So we need to select Arabidopsis thaliana as best matching species. And here you can see here we need to upload expression data in the form of CSV or the text file. And because we are using read counts data, so here I will use gene counts data. You can see here the gene counts file. I will just simply click on open, and here we need to upload our design file. So we can go browse and select our design file. You can see here our gene counts and the design file have been selected, and it is now converting the data. You can see the upload is completed, and here study design and gene read counts data is uploaded. So for WGC analysis, you can skip all of these steps and can directly go to this network tab, because all of these steps belongs to the RNA-seq analysis, and I have already prepared separate video. If you are interested in learning RNA-seq analysis doing IDEP tool, so you can go through the details of all of this. But if you only require to do WGC analysis, you can simply click on this network tab. You can see here it is now constructing the gene expression network. You can see here gene dendrogram and module colors have been appeared. So it is important to note that in different papers, some people are using soft threshold of 5, some people are using soft threshold of 10. So how we can choose our soft threshold? So for this, we can simply click here. You can see here the scale free topology module fit. You can see in the x-axis and the y-axis, here is the soft threshold power. And here you can see the values of R square is 1 when we are using soft threshold of 10. And here meanwhile at the 10, the mean connectivity is very less. So at this point, when the R square value is equal to 1, so we can use that value as soft threshold. Here the line is touching between 10 to 12, so we can also use 10 to 12 as our soft threshold. So we can simply increase soft threshold to 10 and see how network of all the genes is divided into how many modules. As we will increase the soft threshold, and here the number of that modules is also increasing. You can see it is automatically updating in the background and creating new modules. Here at the soft threshold of 10, a network of 961 genes was divided into 7 modules. And interestingly, here each modules can be seen separately. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. The first one is turquoise module, which have highest number of genes, 219 genes. Blue has 192 genes, and similarly all the modules can be downloaded. The enrichment database, they are using the Go biological processes. From here you can select all available gene data set. And here you can see the most number of enriched pathways among the all selected module. And this table is actually showing the number of genes related to any specific pathway. So you can see here the adjusted p-value of all these enriched pathways is very high and negative, which is showing that all of these pathways are highly significant. So similarly, we can download the list of all modules by clicking on this. You can see here a list of all modules have been downloaded. You can see here is the gene ID, and here is the first module, that is turquoise, and here all modules, those genes which belong to blue, and similarly all 7 modules have been downloaded. So let me go back and explain further. File can also be directly imported to WIS and or the Cytoscape. And here you can see a network. In this network, you can see there are 2 central hub genes. You can see here our network layout. We can also change the network of this layout. You can see here the hub genes like DG81 and RVE8. These are actually the 2 central genes which are co-expressing with your module which you have selected. You can also similarly select blue. You can see here in the blue there are the different up genes, and similarly in the brown module there are different. So if you want to compare all the genes of all modules, so you can simply click on this heat map. You can see here a heat map of identified modules have already been generated. You can see here each module is being represented through one unique color. And here are the types of treatment of the sample which we have uploaded previously. So if you want to save this gene dendrogram and module colors of this dynamic tree cuts, you can simply click here and save this dendrogram as individual figure, and you can use it in your publications. You can see here. That gene dendrogram have been saved in high quality resolution. So in this way, you can also perform WGC analysis of your experiment if your sample size is more than 15. So let me show you that what are recommendations. So here are the recommended practices for WGC analysis. In the first step, you can see as the number of the sample would be more, there would be the more robustness, which shows that the results are more refined. So at least there should be 15 samples. And WGC analysis is designed to be unsupervised method, so there is no need to filter the genes by differential expression. And if you are using RNA-seq data, so you should remove all those features which are consistently showing low counts. And data should be normalized by using any method, whether it is RPKM, RFPKM plus one. Any normalization method you can apply, and batch effects need to be adjusted if present before running the analysis. So hope so this IDEP tool would be useful in performing WGC analysis without any requirement of coding. But if you have still any question, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.